I'd like to include a lesson on journal entries in this Accounts Receivable Customer Advanced course. The reason I'm including this is because I want all my students to be able to adjust for unearned income. And you will only be able to adjust for unearned income if you know how to make journal entries. Actually, adjusting for unearned income will be the last video in the series, and it will be the video that follows this one. You need very little accounting knowledge to understand what a journal entry is. Maybe about 3 beginning chapters of any beginning basic accounting course. But if you don't know what it is, I will do my best to show you just enough about journal entries for you to be able to make them when you need to. A journal entry is the way to adjust or correct the account balances for the accounts that are in the chart of accounts without actually entering transactions. These corrections are usually called adjustments. Now, the journal entry window is not only used to adjust the accounts. There are very, very few transactions that require a journal entry, and we're going to give you 2 examples in this video. But remember, usually the journal entry window is meant for adjustments and corrections that your accountant, not the bookkeeper, will put in. We all remember the main report is the trial balance. And I have told the students at the very beginning and basic level, you don't need to have any accounting knowledge to be able to understand QuickBooks. The trial balance is simply a list of the ending balance or the accumulated result in every account in the chart of accounts. But what non-accounting students might have noticed is that some of the account balances are listed on the left side, which is called the debit side, and some of the account balances instead are listed on the right side, which is called the credit side. Now, I can promise you, if you only want to study QuickBooks and you don't want to study any accounting, you don't need to know the reason why some of these accounts are listed on the left side as debit balances and the other accounts are listed on the right side as credit balances. That would be knowledge that you would get at the very, very beginning of an introductory basic accounting course. But you don't need to know why. The only thing you need to know is QuickBooks will know which accounts belong on the left side as debit and which accounts belong on the right side as credit. Now, this is Holden's entire trial balance, but if we just take the piece of the trial balance that we're going to be working with, let's say the top half, and we compare the trial balance to the Make Journal Entry window, what you will notice is that both the trial balance and the Make Journal Entry window have a debit side and a credit side. Now, why is that? Well, it's very simple. If you want to adjust one of the accounts on the debit side, it means you either want to increase it or decrease it. So it's a very simple rule. If you want to increase one of the, okay, for example, for a debit side account, here's what you would do. If you want to increase one of the accounts that's listed on the debit side of the trial balance, you would record the money amount that you want to increase it by in the debit side of the journal entry window. But if you wanted to decrease one of the debit side accounts, you would put that money amount, the money amount that you want to decrease it by, you would put that in the credit side of the Make Journal Entry window in order to decrease it because it is a debit side account. And the opposite is true for credit side accounts. If you wanted to increase one of these credit side accounts, then in the journal entry window, you would record that increase on the credit side. But if you wanted to decrease one of these credit side accounts, in the make journal entries window over here, you would record that decrease on the debit side. And we're going to show you an example right now. Let's imagine on August 7th, Holden, the owner of the company, invested into the business some furniture, which counts as under the account of assets. And that was furniture he was using in his home until today, August 7th. We're pretending today is August 7th. Now, the fair market value of that furniture today, which we're pretending is August 7th, is $1,000. Usually an official licensed appraiser would give you the fair market value. But let's assume we know the fair market value on August 7th of the asset that Holden is investing into the business. Well, what should be the result if Holden takes $1,000 of his personal assets and invests it into the business? Well, this is what the trial balance looks like, or at least the top half. This is what it looks like before you record this transaction. If the company has $1,000 more in assets, that means after you make the journal entry, instead of $1,150 as your balance for assets, your balance for assets would be $2,150. And because Holden is investing from his personal assets, that means that this number, Holden's capital, should increase by the amount he invests, $1,000. So if it were recorded properly, Holden's capital will increase to $2,620. And after we make the journal entry properly, assets will also increase to this, $2,150. Once you see how to record this first journal entry, it will be clear and you will understand. From the main menu, click Company, Make Journal Entry. And the journal entry window opens up. Don't worry about assigning numbers. We're not dealing with that now. This is our first journal entry, and we're going to put number one. Now, be careful about this check mark. This journal entry that we are about to make is not an adjusting entry. It is a transaction. And as I said before, usually you make adjustments in this window and you would click this adjusting entry box, and we'll show you what effect that has in a moment. But because this is a transaction, it's one of the very few transactions that you should make in the journal as a journal entry, leave this unchecked. The date of the transaction was August 7th. Now, what do we do? Well, we know that if you're investing an asset, that the asset account will change. Click directly under the account title heading in this column, then you get the arrow. Click on the arrow and you get all of the accounts in your chart of accounts. This asset account is the one that's increasing. And if you remember from a moment ago, assets are on the debit side. So because we're increasing something on the debit side, we click in the debit column and we type the money amount. To save the money amount in the field without closing the window, look on the left side of your keyboard and push the tab key. Now on the next row under assets, click, and the computer knows for every debit there's an equal credit. So what should be the account that goes on the credit side? Well, if Holden is investing anything in his business, that means his capital in the business goes up. So you choose Holden's capital, which is an equity account. If you remember from a moment ago, capital is listed on the credit side, the right side. And Holden's capital is increasing because he invested more into the business. So it would be debit the assets $1,000 and credit the capital for $1,000 because they are both increasing. After you click save and close, you can open the trial balance and you can see Assets have increased to the amount we predicted a moment ago, 2,150, and Holden's capital increased to the amount we predicted a moment ago, 2,620. Example 2. Let's imagine on August 8th, our bank charged us a fee for something unexpected. $20, what will be the result? Well, if we have $20 less in Chase Bank, then instead of $1,300, after we record this, it'll go down to $1,280. And if we just pay $20 additional in bank fees will increase to $77. And just on a side note, let's click the adjustment box in this one just to see what happens. From the main menu, click Company, Make Journal Entry. Click OK for the journal entry number, and the date is August 8th. Now, we'll click this just to show you something after we're done with this entry. However, let's talk about this. The Chase Bank is on the debit side, and we are decreasing it. So if we're decreasing an account that's normally on the debit side, we have to put that decrease here on the credit side. So we choose Chase Bank, and on the credit side, because Chase is going down, we put $20. On the next row, we put the bank fees. Now let's think about this. Should the bank fees be on the debit side, the way the computer is putting it, to balance out? Well, we know that bank fees are normally on the debit side, and bank fees are increasing. So because we're increasing something that's normally on the debit side, we should put that increase on the debit side, the left side. So if the bank takes money for a bank fee, it's credit the bank account balance to decrease it, and debit bank fees to increase it. After we click Save and Close, you can see the numbers are exactly what we expected. Chase Bank went up to $1,280 and bank fees went up to $77.